back to my channel. I'm Auntie Tay. If you guys are new here, that's who I am. And if you're not, welcome back. Today I am showing you guys how to make something, they're t-shirts. I'm showing you how to make two different t-shirts with one SVG, and I decided to use the Aurora bundle because Aurora, at the end of the movie, has the make it pink, make it blue, so I thought it would be really cute to cut this SVG out of two different colors and then also tie-dye two shirts, two different colors, so that you could, I don't know, it says, let's be dreamers together. It's kind of hard to see on this one because we're a little overexposed on the camera, but it says, let's be dreamers together. And I thought this would be a really cute way for you to Disney bound as Aurora with maybe a BFF or a sister or something fun, and you could have two different colors so you're not wearing the exact same shirt. So let's get going. I talk about all the products in this video, and I may have a matching koozie. If not, it'll be in another tutorial. We're trying to debut all of our SVGs, not all of them, but give you guys kind of a behind the scenes sneak peek to what my members get. So you're gonna be seeing a lot of projects using a lot of HTV, but if you don't know how to use HTV, it is okay because I have other tutorials on my YouTube channel that will teach you all about it and all about cutting products and all those things. So let's get going. All right guys, we're on AuntieTay.com and we are gonna be downloading the Aurora SVGs. So I'm just gonna walk you guys through where to find them on the website as a member. If you're not a member, go ahead and come over here and sign up. We have an $8 a month membership, or if you want commercial rights to these, it's $13 a month. We also have a business membership, which is $25 a month. Super exciting, fun things always happening over here. So check that out. All right. I'm gonna show you guys a different way to get to our Disney characters. If you're on the front of our page and you're just scrolling down, we also have links to Disney right here. So I'm going to click Disney, and it's gonna take us to our Disney landing page, which has all the bundles for all the different categories. Today we are working with princesses, so I can either click the button or I can click the picture of Ariel. She might change over time, but princesses is always going to be princesses. So once we're in here, we've got all of our downloadable bundles that are inspired by our lovely princess characters. We also have some personal use down at the bottom, so if they're any of the files underneath this line, you can use them as much as you want for commercial or for personal use only. Anything above here, if you have our commercial use bundle or membership, you can sell awesome things with these things on them. Okay, so right now we are doing, what princess are we doing right now? Did I say we were doing, we're doing Aurora. Okay, so we're gonna go down to Aurora and we have two bundles. We have another one coming soon. If you notice an opening soon, that means we're working on a bundle for that princess or that character. But today we are using the Let's Be Dreamers Together. So I really wanted to showcase some of the ones that you might miss because they're little or they're in the bundle, and just want to show you fun ways to use them. So I'm just going to click this and one step download. These are going to go into your downloads on your computer as a zipped file. This is the Namaste bundle. So I'm just going to open this. A lot of people get stuck right here because they think that you can upload this file, which you cannot do. So you have to unzip it basically by opening it. So you can either double click it or you can right click and open, and then it will look like this. We have a few different styles of bundles. One like this, where all the SVGs are in one SVG. This makes it super fast and easy to upload to Cricut Design Space, which we'll do in a second. But we also have other bundles that come individually, like this Pocahontas bundle right here. When you download it, it comes with individual files, which can, because we have some print and cut in there, which can take a little longer to upload to Cricut Design Space, but at the same time, they're both bundles and they both work very well, and they have lots of designs included in them. So this one, I'm gonna show you real quick how to drag it into Silhouette Studio. I have Silhouette Studio open right here. I do have the business edition. If you want more details on what that entails, watch the Silhouette Studio, how to download our SVGs into Silhouette Studio video, which will walk you through more in detail with the step-by-step instructions. So all you have to do is drag your SVG once it's open onto Silhouette Silhouette Studio, and you can work with it from there. For this specific project, I'm going to ungroup them, delete all the ones I am not using. I always do that. I select the line tool. So I'm going to delete these. You can also bundle some of these. Like if I really wanted to put this crown on there, now that I'm doing this after the craft is actually done, that would be so cute. So we would resize it to what we want on the shirt and we would go from there. Again, if you want to know more on exactly how to do this, I have a tutorial on that. So let's go over to Cricut Design Space and upload the same SVG just so we can see how to do that. I'm gonna open a new project, go to upload, go to browse. I'm sorry if I'm going too fast, but I really did just want to show you guys how to get these files and get them in there. And again, we have more in detail tutorials on my YouTube channel if you want that. So I'm just going to upload these, click this, put it into Cricut Design Space, and then ungroup it by right-clicking ungroup, hover over what I don't want, delete it, and I'm going to resize this to about 10 inches. I did do this for Landis and her friend, so it was a little bit smaller than 10. 10 is usually what I do for adult size shirts. But since we did this on two different colors, I think we cut this out of pink and this out of blue. So I'm just going to zoom out and drag over everything, Control C, Control V, or Command C, Command V if you're on a Mac. And I'm going to change the colors to blue to remind me that we want this one out of pink and this one out of blue. And then we did all of these. I'm going to attach and turn them into white and turn these into white as well. And then make sure that they are the size we want them, and we'll go from there. So again, this part of the tutorial was really just to show you where the file was for this craft, to upload it, and to go forward from there. That was really fast, but I have very basic beginner tutorials on any of this if you want to know more on how to upload your designs and work with SVGs in your studio or design space. All right, for the Dream Without Fear koozie, I am using Glitter HTV in fluorescent pink. This is Caesar brand. It's available on shopantite.com. I'm just ironing it onto felt, and if you want to see more of how to do the no-sew koozie, I have a tutorial specifically on it with all the details that you'll need. So I'm just using our Aurora Dream Without Fear and putting that in the center, and then continuing to make the koozie as I would any other time, and this will look perfect with any of the other Aurora SVGs.